Today we're going to talk about 7.6, which is proportions and problem solving with rational expressions. So we are going to have problems that are proportions, which are kind of a special case of how you can solve them, but you can still solve them the same exact way as we did 7.5. And we're going to deal with rate of work problems in this specific video. So I just wanted to remind you of the rules for what we went over in 7.5. If you have an equation, you can always clear the denominator by multiplying by the LCD every term. That's the key piece. Then you're going to solve the resulting equation. Usually it's going to be a linear equation. There will be some cases it's quadratic, so please make sure you're comfortable with both because both will be on the test. And you can always check your answers. So we're going to first start off with proportions, and I want you to actually realize that this is kind of what we call a special case. Proportions are where we have a rational expression equals a rational expression, or again, in the terms that most of y'all would think of, it's the fraction equals a fraction. If it's a fraction equals a fraction, or a rational expression equals a rational expression, you can cross multiply. That's the key. So we multiply up. I tend to draw the arrows just to show that. This only works if it's a proportion. Okay. So looking at our first example here, it is x over 10 equals 5 over 9, which is going to fit our proportion. So we have 9x equals 50. Divide both sides by 9 and double check, can I simplify it? This is also a key piece. Please look in the directions in my math lab in the parentheses after. Do they want a fraction format? Do they want a decimal format? Because if you use a different format than they ask, it's going to be marked wrong. So 50 over 9 is my answer. If I had done it the other way, we would have used an LCD of 90. It still would have given us the same answer. Going to number 2. If I were to use my first technique, which we wrote down, we would have done 3 times 2x plus 3. Times both terms. This is again a special case where I can clear my parentheses. Be careful. Make sure you put a parentheses around any binomial when you're multiplying. Yes, you can go ahead and do that. Just be careful. Make sure you distribute it across. So we end up with 3x plus 3 equals 4x plus 6. I need to subtract to move things to the same side. And again, I generally move mine to the left always for just keeping the same format. So I'm subtracting 4x from both sides, which gives me a negative 1x. I'm also going to subtract 3 from both sides to move it to the right side, which gives me negative x equals 3. I'm just going to cross these out so that you can see that these were canceling. And so be careful. Now I need to divide or multiply by a negative 1, which means that my answer is a negative 3. Please always, and I didn't mention this in the first example, but make sure it's not a restriction because that's still important anytime you have a rational expression in a problem. So it's made it a rational equation problem. You need to double check. The first one had no variables in the denominator, so there were no restrictions. The second one I had a restriction because 2x plus 3 cannot equal 0, so x cannot equal a negative 3 halves. I would subtract the 3 and 2, and that's not a restriction, so it's good. Best check always is still to plug it back in. So I want you to remember, we have rules that we can follow for when we have a rational equation. Proportions are a special case of this, and it's easier to solve by cross-multiplying. So our second type of problems we're going to look at in this section, and we're going to use actually some of the ideas from 7.5 and then also proportions, is rate of work problems. And I want you to realize it's still the same idea as rate times time, and normally we would have done rate times time equals distance or something like that, but we're going to set these problems up slightly different. So I like to label them a little differently than what they do in the textbook. So they say hours to complete the job, and I just write down the word time because that's what I'm looking at. And then the second part is my rate, part of the job that they complete in an hour. And I want you to stop and realize that you know what this means. If I tell you can complete a job in 3 hours, and then I say, well, how much of the job did you complete in 1 hour? You should be able to answer to me that you would finish 1/3 of the job the first hour, 1/3 of the job the second hour, and 1/3 of the job the third hour. So my rate is one-third of the job per hour. So we're going to use that idea. So I want you to pause this and read the problem, and then we'll set it up. So Melanie can sort a batch of recyclables in 2 hours. So the time she does by herself is 2 hours. And that's important. The time here is by themselves in that first column. Nicole needs 3 hours to complete the same job. If they work together, how long will it take? So one of these will always be X, always. And two of them, they're going to give you the information. I like to draw a line here just so it's signaling to myself that the times above are by themselves and the time below is together. So this is where we're going to now use that idea of 1 over X, 1 over the time is what their rate is. So Melanie completes a half of the job in 1 hour. Nicole completes a third of the job in an hour. Together, and this tends to throw people off, but it's not any different. It would be 1 over X. We will always set these problems up the same exact way. This last column will be our equation. Melanie's part of her job plus Nicole's part equals the time rate together. So rate Melanie plus rate Nicole equals the rate together. We are now going to stop and realize that this equation right here, it needs to be on your paper. Okay? The chart is really super helpful, but we're not going to mark you wrong if you don't have the chart. We are going to mark you wrong if you don't have this equation. So if you miraculously come up with the answer, that's great, but the points are going to be deducted once we look at your paper. So when we look at this, we're going back to 7.5. We figure out our LCD, and our LCD here is 6x. So 2 times 3 times x, because nothing's in common. X can't equal 0, and that actually should make sense. It's a restriction. It doesn't make sense for 0 to be the time together. So we're now going to multiply every single term by 6x, and that's really important. Again, every term. So remember what I've said. Underline if you need to get in that habit. So here, 2 goes into 6 3 times, so we're left with 3x. 3 goes into 6x. And it leaves me with a 2x. And the last term, the x's cancel, and I'm left with a 6. So I'm left with the equation 3x plus 2x equals 6. These are like terms. So I add 3x plus 2x, which gives me 5x. And then I divide both sides by 5. What I like about a chart is there's no confusion about what I just solved for. X is the time together, which is what we wanted to know. This is again where you need to look at the parentheses in my math lab after the answer blank. If it says give me an integer or a fraction form, which they still expect to be simplified, you can type in 6/5 or you can type in 1 1/5. Remember, 1 1/5 is actually a mixed number. 6/5 is an improper fraction. But why I like to rewrite it, at least in my head, to know 1 1/5 is reasonable, because if they're doing them together, they should be able to finish the job quicker than one of them can do it by themselves. So my answer is 6/5 or 1 1/5 hours. All right, so now going to number 4. Again, please pause this, read the problem, and see if you can set it up correctly. When you think you've set the problem up, come back to the video and make sure you've set it up correctly. Pause again and see if you get the right answer. Because again, it's helpful to listen, but some of you need to actually do the actions. We learn by practice. So reading this problem, we have one custodian that can clean a suite of offices in 3 hours. So I'm going to put the 3 for the time again. And I have a rate, which means the first custodian's rate is 1/3. A second worker is asked to join. The job takes only 1.5 hours. And this is where you got to be careful. The 1 1/2 is when they're working together. So that is in this spot here. How long does it take the second worker to work the job alone? So the second worker's time by themselves is our variable we're trying to find, which means their rate is 1 over x. So those two are pretty easy to fill out. We come into an issue right now, and this is why we're doing this one as an example, because the setup isn't really what I'm worried about you making sure you have down. It's knowing how to deal with the little small things that happen. So the first thing I need you to realize is 1 1/2 is the same thing as 1 times 2 plus 1, which gives me 3/2. So again, what I did is take the denominator times that whole number, it gives me 2, add it to the numerator, which gives me 3, but we keep the denominator. So those are equivalent. Normally, in my rate, and I'm going to write it down here just so we're clear, we would have done 1 over the time, which is what we've been doing. So this would mean I have 1 over 3/2. It's super important. You have to convert this to an improper fraction to do this problem. You can't use a decimal. You're not going to get the right answer. It's really important that you understand this piece. So I'm going to go back to thinking about this. This is 1 divided by 3/2, which means keep, change, flip. So I get 2/3. So my rate is equal to 2/3. That is the hard part for this problem. We're now going to set up our equation by this last column. I have 1/3 plus 1x equals 2/3. This is my equation that I'm looking to see on your paper, did you have? And if you do not have this and you happen to get the right answer, points will be deducted. Very important. We are looking for the equation and the work that corresponds with it. Some people tend to magically come up with the answer, and that's not acceptable. So we're going to now, again, figure out the LCD. LCD here is 3x. X cannot equal 0, which is still, again, it makes sense. So I put my LCD times each term, and when I do this, I get an x plus 3 equals 2x. Just so you're clear on what I just did, again, I canceled the 3s for the first term, left me an x. Canceled the x for the second term, it left me with a 3. Canceled the 3s and left me with a 2x on the right-hand side. So in this case, I'm going to subtract x from both sides. It gives me 3 equals x. Let's look at where that is. That is the time for the custodian, second custodian by themselves. So my answer here should be 3 hours. Yes, that's a reasonable answer. This actually would be a problem if you stopped and reasoned it out. It should absolutely make sense that if they actually both take 3 hours together, that they will half that time, which is 1 1/2 time. So I get that it makes sense, but we want to see the work. So chart is not absolutely mandatory, but equation is, and showing the work of how to simplify.